It's a beautiful weather, pretty warm, and look at that sky. How could sky look on product photography as a background? So let's find out. Welcome back to my channel. It's about photo inspirations, and in today's video I would like to show you how I got sky to my product photography as a background. I'm going to show you how I usually make it, and all you will need will be just a mirror. So first of all, let's try a real sky. However, you have to catch the right moment when you want to get some clouds into your photo. Take some walk, find nice calm place and prepare your scene. I will take some product photography of two perfumes, but you can use this trick also on any other product you like. The mirror should be big enough to have it all in the frame. If you like it, you can use various angles to get some flowers and grass into composition. Photos are just perfect, but the disadvantage of this photoshoot is that you have to take a mirror with you. So now I would like to show you much more comfy way how to get sky into your product photography, and without a real sky. So we are in a studio right now where we will continue, and except mirror, you will need a picture of sky. So as you can see, I don't have any wallpaper or poster of sky here, so I will have to use a digital one. Let's search for sky wallpaper. You can see tons of results, but I like to use images which are free to use. Choose big pictures with good resolution. You can prepare two or three variants. Put the mirror in front of the monitor, set the product, and you can start taking pictures. I have to tilt the monitor to get the digital sky into reflection in the mirror. Now you may ask, what if I don't have a big screen? How will I take photos of products? You can also use your MacBook with a smaller mirror, but this will be suitable only for smaller products. However, you can take the photos and finish the edges in post-processing, but this will be much more complicated. So it all depends on the size of your product. The smaller product you have, your scene can be smaller, but on the other hand, here comes another issue, and it's lens. When you have just small scene, you will have to use macro lens or lens with a short minimal focus distance. If you don't have such lens, the bigger scene will be the right solution. Now let's compare the results from the real and digital sky. Can we see any difference? I think on the first side definitely not, but I better like the digital background. It has a lot of advantages. You have a better control of light conditions when you are taking photos in your studio. Outside without any additional gear like filters and diffusers, the results won't be so great. In addition, you have various skies to choose. Night sky? No problem. Sunset? Also no problem. You don't have to wait for the right part of the day or season. So now it's time for you to take a camera and take some creative photoshoots. See you in the next video. So we are in the studio right now where we will continue.